Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question came during a seminar last week in Oklahoma City. You know, I always show how to shoot a formula down, right? We double click the fill handle and it figures out how many rows we have in the next column, copies it down, and someone stopped me right there and said, hey, wait, I need to record a macro that'll do that. And sure enough, when you turn on the macro recorder and do this, it hard codes that it copied down to row 21. So tomorrow, if you have more rows or less rows, it is not going to work. Let me play that macro back here. Hang on, Alt F8. And see, didn't go far enough. All right, so very frustrating. I said, all right, I bet there's a way that not using the macro recorder that we could actually figure this out. And the macro is going to take advantage of something called the current region. Current region is what you get when you are in a cell and you hit Ctrl asterisk. Right, it extends that section out till it hits blank rows or the edge of the spreadsheet all the way around. And so conceptually, I'm going to have the macro look at the current region and figure out how many rows there are, figure out what row I'm in, and then figure out how far down to copy. So let's take a look at that macro. It's just a 3 or 4 line macro. This is the recorded one. You can see that they hard coded things there. Let's go over to the one that I wrote here. All right, so first thing, a couple of variables, 3 variables. I'm going to use first one called row count. From the active cell, hit the current region, in other words, shift asterisk, figure out how many rows you have and count those. Next up, final row, take the active cell.current region and from the collection of rows, go to the very last one and see what row it's on. So in this case, that would tell me that I'm down in row 24. And then to figure out how many rows to copy, take that 24 minus the current row, which in this case is 4, and add 1. So that's going to give me rows to copy. And then once I have that, once I know how far I want to copy, take the active cell and copy it. The destination is going to be from the active cell, resize rows to copy dot comma 1. So copy down. All right, now let's give this a try. First of all, we're going to assign a shortcut key to that. So I click macros, copy down, options. Oh geez, I don't know what to do. Let's do Control Shift A. So I press Shift A in there, click OK, click cancel to close, and we have our formula here, Control Shift A, and bam, it copies it right down. We'll try that again with a lesser number of rows and make sure that it works. Put a new formula out here, equal to times that, and Control Shift A, and there we go. So, you know, I don't know what's faster than double clicking the fill handle, but he wanted a nice shortcut key that people could do. Conceptually what double click the fill handle does, and a great way to go, a 4-line macro here. Certainly you'll never get this with a macro recorder, but easy enough to add this to your personal macro workbook and have it available all the time. All right, hey, well, tomorrow's Thanksgiving here in the United States, so there'll be no podcast tomorrow. We'll be back on Friday, and don't forget, as you're going out shopping on Friday, the big start of the retail Christmas season, go to the Mr. Excel store. A coupon code of Turkey20, save 20% off on your order from the Mr. Excel store on Friday. All right, well, hey, have a great long weekend. For those of you who don't have to work, we'll catch some of you on Friday. The rest of you, we'll see you on Monday.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.